Well, hey everyone, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am back with another 10 cards, one kit video featuring the Spellbinders card kit of the month for July 2019. I'm opening it up now and you can see that there is tons of goodies in here. It's always packed with great stuff. So of course you've got your 10 envelopes and card bases. We have the dies for the month that are in the kit, and I will go into that a little bit in just a minute. We have some tape, of course, some foam squares, and then of course we've got some really beautiful stickers, and these are really great foam sentiment stickers that I end up using quite a few times throughout the video and through my cards because I just really love the way that it looks. And it takes up a nice chunk of the card, which is nice when you want a nice big sentiment. Here, of course, we've got the die cuts that are included in the kit. I love using these die cuts on my card because, one, it makes it easy, but they're also so beautiful. The colors, and it's cut perfectly. They're really great quality, so I love using those on my card. You saw some sparkly gems there. Of course, we have the stamp set, which is the add-on for the card kit, as well as this paper pad, which is absolutely beautiful. It's got a few sheets per pattern, and I had to go back to this one because I love it, and you'll see that I use that on a card later as well. We have another sort of bonus sticker pack in this kit. It's really beautiful. I use these a few times. And then of course we've got the cardstock that comes in the kit. It's gotten really beautiful coordinating colors for a beach theme or a mermaid theme. And then we've got the silver mirror cardstock. I'm going to go right into the dies that you get included in the kit this month. And there are a few extra dies that I don't show here in the video. And those are sort of to help make a scene with this mermaid. So there's a few bubble dies. I think there's a shell die. There's also some seaweed dies, like the die cuts that are in the actual kit as well, which really makes it great when you're trying to create the scene with your mermaid. But I really wanted to focus on how to put this mermaid together and assemble her so that she looks beautiful and so that you know where all the pieces go. Because sometimes when there's lots of dies like this, it can be a little intimidating, but Spellbinders always does a really great job of making it pretty easy to figure out. It's pretty self-explanatory, but I'm gonna go into it anyway. So here I've got all of the pieces laid out for you. What I'm putting out right now are the elements of the face. So there's lips, eyes, and then cheeks as well. Now the cheeks I don't end up actually using on my mermaid today. I think they're really cute, but I ended up just coloring it in with a Copic marker. And I did that just because I wanted a little bit more of a subtle look. But if you'd like the bolder look of maybe like blush or something like that, I definitely implore you to use those die cuts. And to make it a little easier, I went ahead and die cut that die out of white cardstock so that I could color in those elements how I saw fit. If I wanted to do it from cardstock in each different color, I would have had to cut it out a few times because all of the face elements are together in one die just to make it easier. So I decided to just use some white cardstock for that. So you can see how I'm assembling the mermaid here. I went ahead and first put the head and bodice piece right into that little cut that's in the hair. So it's really beautiful because it looks like it's nice and flowing down her back. I then went ahead and put the tail on with the fin, and that makes it pretty clear to see where I need the arms with the shell top. And then there's a little top piece for her tail that I glued on. That just sort of makes it cohesive and look like she's got a full mermaid suit happening. I'm not sure exactly, a mermaid body. And then of course I went ahead and put in all of the elements for the face again, except for the cheeks. And then I used that little starfish dye or star dye. I thought it looked like a little flower, so I went ahead and put that in her hair. To create the card, I trimmed a piece of pattern paper down to 4 by 5 1/4, which is just slightly smaller than an A2 size card. And I used this scale foiled piece of pattern paper. I thought obviously it was perfect for the mermaid and I really loved the color. And for the sentiments, I actually picked out some of the die cuts included in the kit. and I adhered them and the mermaid with foam tape to the card front. Now, this is the only time that I show this part of the process in the video, but just know that all of my card fronts get attached to the included card bases with foam tape. And here is the final product of this card. I think it's so sweet. It's really great just for a hello to a friend for the summer, or if you added a happy birthday sentiment, it's great for that as well. Moving into card two, I wanted to make something that was maybe a little less girly or a little less feminine. I knew that most of the cards I was going to make from this kit were going to be very feminine. It had a very feminine mermaid vibe, obviously. So I wanted to see if I could make one card that didn't really scream beach or mermaid. So I went ahead and used the foam sentiment stickers, and I used Magic, Love, and Dream, and sort of just space them out evenly on this piece of pattern paper that I use that has a very similar writing on it. And I also trimmed that down to 4 by 5 1/4, and then just cut off the excess of those sentiment stickers. And it was the easiest card to make, I swear. Maybe there's one more easier later on in the video, but I really like the way that this came out, and I like that it has a different vibe than the rest of my cards. For card number three, I'm using mostly the die cuts included in that pack that's in the kit. This one here is actually the film strip itself is its own die cut, which I'll show you here in just a minute. But the actual people inside, or the animals inside, were separate die cuts included in the kit that I just trimmed down to make it look like they were in a photo booth together. And I thought that was really sweet, and this would be a perfect, again, summer hello card for a friend. For the sentiment, I'm actually using a tag die cut that's also included in the pack. It says, "My besties help me be my best self." And then another tiny sentiment strip die cut that says photo of the day. I'm adding a little elements of starfish and shells here and there, a little bit of like that metallic or holographic seaweed type leaf. And then I'm using, again, the foam sentiment stickers that say smile, or one that says smile, because it just works so perfectly with all the die cuts. And for the patterned paper in the back, again, I trimmed that down to 4 by 5 1/4, and then adhered that to an A2 size card base that's included in the kit. Card number four is the card I was talking about when I said I think there might be one easier card in the video. I used 2 foam stickers from this set that's gorgeous, that I love, and that's pretty much it. So what I decided to do, because I wanted this to take up a nice chunk of the card, was I decided to make a 4-bar card. So that's 4 7/8 by 3.5. And I'm just adhering these stickers, and it's really great to know that these stickers will actually remove really easily from the pattern paper if you don't put a lot of pressure on it right away. So I was able to just sort of figure out where I wanted it and where exactly it should be. And I actually moved it down a bit, and there was no tearing. And then I just trimmed my card base down as well. So all the card bases that come in the kit are A2 size, which is 4 1/4 by 5.5, but I just trimmed mine down to make it fit for my 4-bar size card. We're already halfway through here. This is card number 5, and I created this background with the outline shell stamp that's in the stamp set that's the add-on for the kit this month. I used a teal color, a pink, and a blue just to sort of vibe with the rest of my cards, because the color palette is very similar. And then I'm using foam tape to adhere this square framed sentiment that says salty kisses and starfish wishes. And this is actually included in the die cut pack as well. So I adhered that with foam tape to the center, and then added some die cut starfish images around because it works really well with the sentiment. I love the way that this came out. Again, it's another great summer hello card. And summer hello cards are so great to send because there's not a lot of holidays happening, obviously, in the summertime. So it's nice just to send as a reminder that you're thinking of someone. Card number 6 is another one that I decided to play around with and make a different shape. So I'm making a mostly square card. The base is actually, I cut it down to 4 1/4 by 4.5, but the actual card front in the pattern paper is cut to 4 by 4 1/4, just so that it's slightly smaller and I get that nice matted background. I've cut the floral pattern paper piece out of a circle nested die and then used the slightly larger circle nested die with the silver mirror cardstock just to create a nice background for it. And then I used a sticker again from that really beautiful foam sticker pack, and it says, "Kind and brave, that's all you ever need to be." And I really love the sentiment in this, so I wanted to make sure that it was the star of the show in this card. I'm moving back to the mermaid vibes for card number 7, and I'm using the two mermaid die cuts that you get in the die cut pack. Now, you actually get two of each of these mermaids, so don't feel like you have to use them wisely because there's extras. But what I did was actually intertwine their arms so it looks like they're sort of arm in arm and they're posing together. And I thought this would just be a really great best friend card. And so I'm going to adhere them with foam tape to this yellow sort of chevron patterned piece of paper that is included in the paper pack. I've cut this down to 4 by 5 1/4, and I thought the yellow looked really nice because it was nice and pale and light, but it helped bring the colors together and helped the die cuts themselves stand out. For the sentiment, I went ahead and used Friends, which is also in that sort of sparkly white foam tape sentiment sticker set, and then used the stamp Mermazing and embossed that in white right over the Friends sentiment, and again adhered that all to the A2 size card base included in the kit. Card number 8 is another one that I focused a lot on the die cuts included in the pack that's in the kit, but I also cut out just the tail portion of the mermaid die so that I could make it look like the tail was just sort of coming up from behind all of these shells. And then I added that little splash piece of die cut there just to make it look like she really dove in. The way I like to adhere my die cuts, because I don't want to lose my place, and I film with my phone, so I can't always go back in with my phone to take a picture so that I can look at it because I'm using it for filming most of the time. So what I like to do is put them all together. I just peel up sort of pieces so that I can adhere them together with glue, and then I have one piece once they're all adhered together, and then I can put that all onto the card front with foam tape, and it just makes it really easy. And that's my favorite way to sort of assemble die cuts and then make sure that they're in the place that I want them to be when I go ahead and adhere it onto my card front. For card number 9, I'm trying something a little bit different. I'm using a coordinating piece of pattern paper with a die cut that is included in the kit. What I'm going to do is actually use this background to sort of like copy off of or enhance, I guess. So what I'm going to do is take that seashell or that oyster that has the pearl in the center, and I'm going to adhere that with foam tape directly over where it is on that piece of pattern paper. I'm going to add a few more bits of seaweed and those greenery leaves in just to make it look more like a three-dimensional scene. But what this will do is use the background that's already created on this piece of pattern paper and enhance it and make it look three-dimensional. I'm using a few fish die cuts and also the sentiment die cut that says "You're a treasure," and I'm putting that directly over the oyster and then adding in a few of those little foam stickers that look like sparkles. I just thought it looked really nice, almost like it was shining from the pearl itself, and I love the way that this one came out. Card number 10 is actually the first idea that I had when looking at all of the products included in the kit. You saw in the beginning that I had to double back at this piece of pattern paper because I loved it so much, and I thought, this just obviously looks like a bunch of water splashing up. And so I knew that I needed to take this Norwal, which was my favorite of all the die cuts, and put him right there in the center to make it look like he's making this splash. So I wanted him to stand out a little bit more, and since his colors are very similar to the colors in the pattern paper, I used some pink and dark blue die cuts in the shells to stand out against the pattern paper. I went ahead and adhered them with the tape so that they were flush against the cardstock, and I didn't want to make them or flush against the pattern paper. I didn't want to make them stand out too much because I really wanted the narwhal itself to stand out the most. So I went ahead and used foam tape for the narwhal, and then I put some of the bubble die cuts going up, and then I thought it would be really fun to add the sentiment die cut right there into the center top, but to make it look like it's part of the scene, I went ahead and put some of the bubbles or part of one of the bubbles over that sentiment so that it looks like it's just right in the middle of the scene itself and that the bubbles are going around the sentiment rather than underneath it to make it look like it was added afterward. I hope that you've enjoyed the video and gotten some ideas on how you can use the products in this month's card kit. As always, all of the links to all of the products used, including the card kit and all of the kits that Spellbinders offers, is in the description, as well as links to my blog and Instagram. Thanks so much again for stopping by. I'll see you again soon. Thank you.